Hello everyone, I'm Shivangi Agarwal and I'm going to discuss about the online professional awareness test, which is the OPAT examination. So it is the stage one of the IFOA's mandatory professional skills training. It is basically a 90 minutes online test whereby you will be given some of the scenarios and you will be asked questions about them and you need to answer them using your professional judgment. This test aims to develop your ability to exercise judgment in compromising ethical situations, including those when you need to seek advice from senior colleagues. Now, it is a free of charge test where you just need to fill up this application form over here, which looks something like this. You just need to fill your name and your ARN and you need to mail this registration form to the IFOA in this particular mail provided here at education.services@actuaries.org.uk, and then within 1 or 2 days you will receive the examination access and you need to appear for the 90 minutes test. Now this test is meant for those who are the student member of IFOA on or after 1st March 2012, and this is a compulsory examination if you want to apply for the CB3 business management test. Also, this is a compulsory test as you need to move on to the stage 2 of the mandatory professionalism test. Now there will be 5 questions asked and all those 5 questions will consist of 3 parts. All these 5 questions will be covering one of the 5 core principles of the actuary's code. The first part of the question will be a direct wording of the actuary's code which will be awarded a 5 marks. The part 2 will be a situation based test and you need to answer on the basis of that situation, which will be awarded a 10 marks. Part 3 will further on develop on this situation given in part 2 and this will be awarded a further 5 marks. So each of the 5 questions will have 20 marks each, and part 2 and part 3 options of the question have different point score to reflect the judgment that you need to apply when thinking about the response. So before appearing for the test, obviously you need to study the actuary's code, which you can do using this particular link. You can just click on this link to download the actuary's code, or I've provided it in my PPT as well. This is the actuary's code. You can download the code from here and read the full code before you appear for the examination. The entire guidance is given over here and you can download it as a PDF to study before you appear for the examination. Also, the institute says that you can keep the actuary's code handy before, you can just keep it handy while you take the test. Now there are some changes which will reflect after 1st July 2020. So after 1st July 2020, the OPAT examination will change into a new stage 1 professionalism course in which you'll have to complete an online course of 3 to 4 hours on the basis of which you'll have to appear for a computer based assessment. After you complete the new stage 1 professionalism course, you move on to the new stage 2 online professionalism course, which I am going to discuss in my later video. If you do not appear for the OPAT now, which is the free of cost examination, then after 1st July, you'll have to appear for the stage 1 new professionalism course, and that will be of £55 in the reduced rate regime. So these are the costs which will be applied after 1st July 2020. Also, this is not meant for those students who are becoming a member of the institute after 1st July 2020. So I repeat, this is not for those students who will join the institute after 1st July 2020 or those who are appearing for their September examination in 2020 as their first paper as a non-member. So it's not meant for students who will become members after 1st July 2020, and for those who are appearing giving their first papers in September 2020 as a non-member. This is only meant for those who are currently the members of the institute and who became the members after 1st March 2012. Also, after you complete the first stage, you'll have to move on to the second stage of the professionalism course, which I'll discuss in my later videos. And this is the online, this is the registration form which you all have to fill it up, and you'll have to mail this to the institute as soon as possible so that you are applicable, you are eligible to appear for the OPAT test. This is a PPT, small PPT which I have made with all the links, with all the important links, and I'll be sharing this on along with my video. So if you have, if you apply for the OPAD before 29th May 2020, then it will be free of charge. So as soon as you apply, you'll get the examination access code within a day or two, and it's very mandatory that you do it as soon as possible, because then only you will be eligible to appear for the test before 29th May 2020. Also, this is only meant for those members who joined the institute after 1st March 2012, and this is not for those students who will become a member of the institute after 1st July 2020. So if you have any queries regarding OPAT, you can contact me regarding this, and you need to apply for the same as soon as you can. Also, I have given the mail IDs where you can send your registration forms to the institute to appear for the examination. Thank you, and I hope my video was informative to you all. Thank you.